Et voilà, c'est fait. Here you go, it's done.
1990.
Mustang. It's an LX, but it's a special edition. And actually, when one of my followers, his name is Brandon, lives here in Montreal, wanted me to paint his Mustang, he says to me, it's a special edition. It's a 7-Up special edition. I thought he was pulling my leg. I was like, what the hell is he talking about, you know? I looked it up. Yeah, there actually is. This is actually a very rare 1990 Mustang 7-Up special edition. Something had to do with, like, they made so many of them, I think, to give away for the Super Bowl or the NFL or something. I don't know. Anyway, I don't remember all the details, but definitely a fun project to do. And, you know, I told him, I was like, you know, what kind of background would you like for this? And he wasn't sure, and I wasn't really sure either. And I looked at the picture for, well, there's the picture he gave me for to do the painting of his car there. And I thought, with the sun there, the low sun in the summertime, and I thought to myself, you know, I like the white leather interior. Well, I assume it's leather. White interior with the dark green. I thought to myself, you know what? Maybe this has like a something you would see more like in the southern states, like in Florida, you know? So I figured, why not do like a, yeah, this Miami Beach kind of a scene. So I just looked at a couple of photos online. I Googled Miami Beach and I put in the palm trees and I put in the cargo ship and some chairs and, you know, of course, there's lots of coats of paint. And I'm sure a lot of you, you know, I'm sure a lot of you, you wonder like, well, Elton, how many hours on average does it take you to do a painting like this? You know, 18 by 24 inches. It takes about, I don't know, 15 to 20 hours, you know. So, a week, about a week. And it was a fun project to do. It's interesting about his car, though, is that those, obviously, if you know old cars well, you know that those are aftermarket wheels, meaning those are not the original wheels. And actually, interestingly enough, the original wheels were GT wheels. They were not the LX wheels that came with this. Now, the hood, I don't know what's the story with the hood. I guess probably had that, again, aftermarket done somewhere, you know. But really, you know, although there's a lot of work in the background with coats of paint and all that, but no, it's really the car itself took a lot of coats and exactitude to get the reflection of the paint, you know, and even this, the raised hood, and, you know, and mind you, of course, these are not the stock headlights, or he's got some kind of tints on them or something. I hate how the fact that this GoPro, like, it shows the battery is already at 39%, it's in a yellow, yeah, but it's still good for a while. Actually, no, I shouldn't say that. It really aren't. This thing sucks up batteries like a 59 Buick Cadillac takes gasoline or Oldsmobile or whatever. But yeah, fun project. And not to make any... Oh yeah, and I forgot to mention, yeah, that's right. We're in my living room because, see, I developed this neck pain on my right, and I thought to myself, maybe it's from all the, you know, constantly looking downward and from the painting and looking downward, not just to get paint, but also to use the picture on, I would always use the picture that was on my cell phone because I found more comfortable to paint in my office because the lighting is better, right? I'm next to the window, there's three lights. Although the lighting is not as good here, I can actually make out all the details much easier and just look over to my left at whatever the wheels or whatever I'm doing. Man, the wheels, just the wheels alone actually took a lot of work. I didn't even think that was going to be the case. And yeah, you know, might as well have you guys take a look here, 23rd of March here in Montreal, what it looks like. Yeah, it's pretty crappy. We haven't had snow like that since I don't know when. Oh, nice charger, yeah. Looks like a police pack. You see that? Kind of goes along with things, doesn't it? You go to car shows, what do you see? You see Mustangs and Chargers and Camaros and Chevelles and so forth. So yeah, so that's it, guys. Not to be a long-winded thing, but if you are interested in having your vintage or old vehicle done by myself, Elton McFall, it's $300 for this kind of work. $20 to ship across Canada, United States. Obviously, if you live further away off, you know, in whatever, Europe or something, Australia, it would probably cost like $50 to ship, I would imagine. I'd have to get back to you on that. And yeah, it's labor of love, but always challenging regardless of what I paint. And it's acrylic, as you can see here, some paint here, mix of new and old paints. And yeah, but it's actually funny because it's larger in here to paint, so there's more, I have more room to move around. And also I got my, you know, my subwoofer here with the speakers, so I got the internet music playing better than rather than from a little Bluetooth speaker, the sound is not as good. And there you go. So, Brandon, I hope you like it. I'm sure you will. And yeah, that's it, guys. So, thanks again for watching. Again, like I said, if you're interested in having a painting done of your vehicle, or doesn't even have to be your vehicle, or whatever, something you know, that I can do for it. I might even do the front of a train or something. Like, I might be able to, you know, I always say like a heavy truck or a train is more work. It is, but maybe there's a way to make it affordable, you know, like not doing the whole thing kind of thing. So anyway, guys, that's it. Thank you very much for watching. I'm looking forward to taking a break here and go chill out with Gloria, because she's already in my room. And there you go, man. You know, take care of yourselves, be well, and all the best. And be nice to people when you can. Eh? It's important today, very important today. Be respectful. And thanks for watching, guys. And I keep thinking I forgot to mention something. I don't know what. Oh, yeah, by the way, if you saw that video of Ed's Mustang there, the blue one, it's for sale. All right, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.